Hi, you guys. Hello, hello today. So I have one of my More Than Rubies Find Your Worth shirts on today. Okay. I have a bag full of them. My bed's kind of messy, so don't mind it. I have a bag full of them. And we're headed to the free gospel fest that they have in Boston every single year. Last time I went to go see my favorite gospel artist. My favorite gospel Christian rock band is Jesus Culture, as you guys know. But my favorite gospel artist is Marvin Sapp. So the first year I ever went to it, they had Marvin Sapp there, and I was stoked. I mean, I was so excited, you guys. You have no clue. Ooh, that spray smells so good. So I have one of my shirts on. The reason why my bed's not made is because all the sheets and stuff are in the dryer. So I have dinner on the stove for Boops for when he comes home. I made a pasta salad for him for when he comes home tonight. I also made... Hey, you guys! Hey. So, I am getting prepared to go to Gospel Fest 2016 in Boston. So, this is my second time going to the Boston Gospel Fest. I went a few years back, and they actually had my favorite gospel artist there, which is Marvin Sapp. My favorite Christian rock band is Jesus Culture. I love Jesus Culture. So I saw Jesus Culture this year. And then back then I saw Marvin Sapp. So it was very good. And I was so excited. So this year Tina Campbell is going to be there. So I'm going to go and enjoy myself. I brought in some of my t-shirts so that maybe I can sell some of my t-shirts there. So I have my Find Your Worth, More Than Rubies, Proverbs 31:10 on it. Just finding your worth and knowing that you're worth it in God's eyes, despite of what society may think of you. I'm gonna try to share the love of Jesus today and all that he has done for me, and share some of my testimony and how God took me off the streets of Boston and helped me find my worth and living to be a better woman and living to change my life so I could become the wife that I am now and hopefully a good mother in the future. From, you know, especially since I grew up in Massachusetts and lived a street life in Boston. So I'm so excited. Off to Boston we go, you guys. Woo! Mind you, today I have to take, I'm taking my car to one of the train stations, and then I'm going to take the train to City Hall. So this is going to be interesting because I have not ridden the train in a few years. So pray for me, you guys, because I don't know what I'm doing anymore. So I gotta charge my camera. I've been charging it, but I guess the charger I was using didn't charge it. So all right, we're going to Boston. Yay.
First off, we'll be doing street doors on the left-hand side.
All right, guys, so I'm gonna work the train in like probably 2 years. So this is gonna be interesting. I dropped my car off at one of the train stations, and so now then I'm going to take the train all the way down to City Hall and then go to the concert. So it's been a while since I've done this. It's interesting because I've been driving for so long. But when I was younger, I used to take the train all the time into the city. So I don't mind the adventure and actually getting out and doing this because it's something that I'm used to, and it's better for me because it's actually getting me out the house to actually do stuff, because since I moved back from Florida, I really haven't been doing anything. So stuff like this gives me the rush that I need to help me with my traveling addiction, because you guys know I love to travel, and I've been traveled in like 4 months. So trains, buses, road trips, stuff like that. That's the stuff that I love. So yeah, I'm gonna guys, I made it. I'm off the train now. I am at City Hall. I just have to go around the opposite side and go find a seat so I can watch the concert. I'm very excited. Faneuil Hall's right over there. And here's City Hall. And yeah, so it's nice. I'm excited. A little tired, but at least Boopy's all set up. He has dinner ready for him for when he gets home tonight. It's in the crock pot. And I get to enjoy myself.
And I'll follow you and carry you. I need a little more of me. Took me down too much in the front way. Bring me up a little bit more in the front way.
Chief Cross alluded to the fact that Boston is definitely a unique place as far as it pertains to community police relations. And we definitely have room for improvement, but in the spirit of that, can we just as a community, can you reach out and grab your neighbor's hand? Somebody you may not know, family member, somebody you may not be familiar with. And let us pray. Father, we come before you this evening, thanking you and praising you for this day. Thanking you and praising you for an administration that understands and appreciates gospel music, that recognizes that many share the Christian faith in this city. And thank you for them providing a venue for us to come in here, national and local bars. God, we pray a special blessing upon this event today. We pray that you would touch every artist, touch every musician, touch the sound man, touch the security, touch everybody that has any and everything to do with this event. We pray a special anointing upon Chief Gross, out of his role as a police officer, but as a man just coming to relax and share with the community. We pray that you would bless him today and then God back in his role. We pray that you would sustain him as the first African-American chief in the city of Boston. We pray that you would fortify him and give him strength and cause him, God, never to be weary in the work that he is doing. We pray for this city. We pray for the mayor. We pray for every cabinet member. We pray for every department director. We pray for every manager. We pray for every fire department official. We pray for every police department official. We pray for public works. We pray for the entire city of Boston and its employees. Yeah. And God, we pray for the residents of this city. We pray that you would cause us to come together and begin to reach out and neighbor to neighbor and get to know one another. God, cause this to be an example to decrease the violence in this city. We pray, God, that today would encourage those, as Tina sings and different people sings, we pray that they would be encouraged to go out and just share love with one another. We pray your blessings from this point forward until the last person that leaves here gets to their home safely. These things we ask in Jesus' name. Everybody say, thank God.
Thank God.
Amen. God bless you.
Amen.
In my view, the road may be bumpy getting there, but I'm pressing through, and I will enjoy this journey, no matter. And a prayer.
Seek him on my knees, and in his word I find out that I'm all good. Cause it's just like you got, anybody got kids out there? Anybody got kids? I got five on it. Five of them. But I'm looking good, ain't I? Don't miss it. Are they right at the crib waiting for me too? When you come home so we can go swimming? Hair and everything, they don't care. They just want to get in the pool. But anyway, my children. I mean, and then look, the little three-year-old that just turned four. I love him with everything in me. The boy done been kicked out of three children's churches. And today, they called us and said he got kicked out. But he didn't hit nobody this time, so I thank God. He's improving. He wouldn't stop playing the piano. He thought he was a minister of music. He wasn't hired for the job, but he thought that he should do the job, so he kept on playing. So they had to escort him back into the church to his nanny. But he didn't hit nobody this Sunday, so I'm grateful to know that he's growing. It's still something that I'm dealing with, my little toddler and everything like that. But even when that boy be wearing me out, and all of the rest of my kids, and they're doing something and they're wearing me out, I still love them. I still see good in them. I don't care what they do. I'm gonna love them because they mine. I don't care if they was busted toe up and they not, but it's they my kids. I love them because they mine. They bad, you say they
you good. Better speak
they
it.
You say they cute. They doing something that's not amazing. Oh, that's so phenomenal because they yours and you love them, right? When I think about the fact that God loves me, just that much?
Yeah.
Y'all, the one who created everything that we see, the one that's sustaining the breath in your body, the one that created your heart and your brain and air and the wind and the trees. I'm his child and he thinks highly of me. So when I'm screwing up and I'm messing up and I feel like I'm not enough, he does just like I do to my kids. Come on, baby. I love you. Come on. You're going to be all
yes.
right.
Yes. Yes.
You all right? You all right? I think you're amazing. I put some good stuff inside of you. And I'm perfecting it. You don't have to work it out by yourself because I'm helping you and I'm guiding you. I sent my son for you because I think you are that important. It's wonderful to know that Jesus loves the whole wide world, but it's awesome to know that Jesus loves me.
Yeah.
And if nobody ever told you, Jesus loves you.
Yeah.
Jesus died on the cross and took on all the sin of the world for you so that you could have power through him to get through everything that you might go through in life, to get through those rough days and those hard times when you feel alone. Just know that if you ain't got nobody, Jesus loves you, and you mean everything to him. I could imagine Jesus singing. I could imagine Jesus singing this to me. When I see your face.
Yeah.